Yes, I did have a mild childhood crush on Ryan from the OC, as I'm sure many people did. It was very interesting when I found out that I was going to be playing alongside him and probably getting the chance to kiss him. I was very excited, and I was with our great uncle Hugh in a car, and I think Ben called me. And yeah, I'd lost my mind a little bit. And because I sort of like screamed when I saw that it was him calling me, my Uncle Hugh crashed into a car behind us. Just a tiny crash, like a bump. And he's like, what is it 84, Hugh?
No, he's 80.
He's 80. So I gave him probably a mild heart attack himself and crashed.
But interesting, as an aside, he almost hit someone whilst I was in the car with him as well.
Oh, well, then maybe it's not me. It's just our Uncle
just
Hugh.
He's a bad driver.
Probably shouldn't be driving anymore. Thank you, Olivia.
Is Alfred actually that English in real life?
Alfred is that English in real life, yeah. Sean Pertwee. Is a total, like, I think cad is what we call them. Like, he's a proper cockney geezer. He's
is
amazing,
it?
Yeah.
Proper geezer.
Proper geezer, yeah. He speaks like that. He's such a lovely person to have on the set. He's always just fun and jolly. He's like, he's got such a childlike spirit. I was going to say childish, that wouldn't be very nice. He's got a childlike spirit, so it's really fun to work with him. There was something about a kipper or something in one of the episodes. I don't know if you guys remember that. But in the read-through, Sean had to basically explain to half of the cast what a kipper was. So he got, like, a picture out. It's a fish. So he got a picture out, passed it around. Like, everyone was like, oh, kipper. Yes, yes. So that was nice. So you guys haven't seen the final episode of this season, have you? So I'm not going to give away any spoilers. I think so. Basically, it was like the coma happened. So before coma, she was mental because of what Olga did, and then post coma, she sort of remembers what happened with the ogre, but she doesn't feel like it was kind of her doing it. She was a bit of a puppet, his puppet. So when now she feels a little bit like she remembers those things, she wasn't in control of herself when she was doing them, so she's got the guilt of it, and she remembers kind of crazy Barbara, but she is now cured to an extent, but still kind of on that roller coaster ride of ups and downs. So you might see her go mental again, but it will be a kind of considered, not as mental, but just sort of she's completely in love with Jim still, and he's now turned her down, so she is still wanting to get back to him, and but she's kind of angry now. So I think you're going to see that more of a kind of woman scorned type vibe off her, rather than just like I'll do anything because I'm a dark creature that she was at the beginning of the second series. If I wanted to be another character, I would probably be I'd give Jerome a go. Jerome.
Woo! Yes.
Even though he's dead now.
Or is he?
Ooh, spoiler.
Tell us about your worst accident that you've had.
Do you know my worst accident? Okay, so when I was... how old was I? Dad, how old was I when I smashed through the window? Seven. When I was seven, we've got a family friend. They're French. Don't trust the French. That's a joke. I love the French. I love the French. So we've got a family friend. Mum's best mate is actually from the Lake District, but she moved to France, and their son Jonathan and I were best mates. Were. Because when we were seven, Jonathan, I used to have this terrible habit of running through doors in my house and then slamming them behind me. And Mum always used to say, be careful because one day you'll hurt yourself. And I was like, no, I won't. And one day, Jonathan and I were playing, I think it was Kiss Catch. It's pretty early on for that. Sorry, Dad. I think it was just childhood friendly fun games. So we were playing like tag. We'll just say tag. And I was running through the door, and I slammed it behind me. And as I slammed it, I was like, oh my God, Jonathan is going to go through this door. So I turned back to open the door, and his head went through the door, and all the glass flew at me and went into my arm here. And this is the only scar that I have, which it looks like a bird. The best bit about the story was all my family were drunk, so no one could take me to the hospital. And then eventually someone sobered up enough. I think it was Christmas or something, and we went to the hospital, and the nurse was drunk, so she stitched me up, and it's probably the worst stitching anyone's ever done. It looks like a huge, like, wavy bird. So there we go.
Story about the ogre in Gotham and Barbara's love for Jim kind of reminds me of the Joker in The Killing Joke. Is there still a slight chance that Barbara might turn out to be the Joker? Or is that dream shattered?
That Barbara might turn out to be the Joker?
Yeah.
Someone told me yesterday she does in one of the comics, which was news to me. I pitched it when Bruno Heller, our creator, took me to dinner. He said, who do you want to be? And I said, Joker. And he said, I don't know about that. So I don't know. I would love her to be Joker. I think she'd be a fabulous Joker. But I don't know whether fans would want that. I don't know. I would want that. We'll see. There we go. Thank you.
Yay! I would.
Single person. If you just write in, you tell a friend and they'll tell a friend.
Because we all know they're going to get back together.
Do we?
Well.
Yeah, okay, we do.
With the, like, do you reckon there's going to be the whole Barbara Jr. and Batgirl thing?
I think that it is something that they're considering. It's probably in the pipeline. I don't know. They don't really tell me very much. But I think it would be a very interesting journey for them to go on, because obviously it's like, now that she's gone this much over into the dark side, how could Jim possibly make that leap? Especially with Lee on the scene and what Lee's been through. It's going to be kind of a really interesting way of finding that journey. So I think that will be a really interesting story to tell. So I do hope that they tell it. I knew from early on that she was very troubled, because there was a piece when I did the audition, there was a piece that I read that had been specially written for her character by Bruno that was never in Gotham. It was just like a separate, completely separate piece of text, and it had a lot of journeying in it through a lot of her kind of like alcoholism and drug taking, and it was a scene between her and Jim. And, you know, he was basically kind of coming home and finding her with some sort of prescription drugs or something along those lines, or talking about that kind of thing. So I knew that there was those kind of lights and shades to her, but there was never, right from the start, I didn't know what was like about the ogre kind of moment. So that was, a brilliant twist that I really was so pleased that they did with her, and I think that it's led to like this really incredibly interesting kind of character now with such a huge range, which is what I'm so grateful that I've got to play. So yeah, I just love this journey that she's on, and I kind of hope that she keeps going in this dark way, because I think it's a really sort of fun thing to watch. I personally read Year One because that's the one that Barbara appears in quite a lot. But I know that a lot of the other casts, like I know that Robin and David especially dipped into the comics a lot. And Geoff Johns was really amazing in kind of supporting Robin in a lot of that stuff. Because obviously their characters are so, they've just been, you know, played so many times in so many different wonderful ways. And there's so much information that they could gather from those comics that I know that they do probably the most research into the comics, and I know that they have some really special editions and all this lovely thing that like the DC world provides, which is just fabulous. So yeah.
What was for you your favorite scene to film, and also what was the most difficult?
So I got asked that question yesterday, and I said that the ogre stuff was one of the best things to film for me, and also one of the most difficult, because that was such a huge moment for Barbara, and like the transition into who she became from where she was so massive, and we had to sort of tell it quite succinctly within three episodes. And working with Milo was like an amazing way to do that. Milo Ventimiglia, who played the ogre, because he, like me, does the kind of acting that we like to do is just kind of put ourselves in a situation and react off each other rather than make decisions and then bring it to the table. So we really were very creative within that process, and obviously the subject matter was quite intense into what was happening and the kind of wider implications of it. So it was really very, very like emotionally draining, but great. And then I guess like some of the most fun stuff I've filmed was the fight with Morena that Lee and Barbara have in the final episode, because I don't know if you know, but we have stunt people on Gotham, and two stunt girls who played us are brilliant, and they did the fight and we did the fight, and they actually ended up using a lot of me and Morena, which we were really chuffed about, and that's all down to the stunt women showing us exactly what to do and really like everyone looking after us. And Norm is our stunt guy and he's incredible, but I was really proud that they used a lot of us in the end results. So that was really fun, and also it was just so fun doing it with Morena, because it felt a bit like dancing. Like, it looks so violent, but when you're doing it, you're really looking after each other, so it's like really beautiful. And what other ones have I loved doing? I mean, I love every day I get to be Barbara, but the stuff with Jerome in the third episode when we were doing all the fun kind of, you know, magician and magician's assistant stuff, that was wicked. It was really good. Thank you. I have lots of advice for actors starting out. It's not easy. Don't expect it to be an easy ride. Get a lot of rejection, so make sure you're okay with that. Do as many other things as you can. So if you can write, direct, produce, film, anything like comedy, if you, in this day and age, like we have now, a DP is like a director of photography. I think that's what we call like a cinematographer here. Like, so if you're a DP, you now have to be able to film your own stuff and direct it. Like, we're condensing everything. So like, they just want less people who can do more. So if you're that person, you've got more chance of getting work. So if you're an actor who also writes and produces, you can obviously just produce and write your own thing and put yourself in it. So I'd say from the earliest point, don't be relying on other people to just give you work, because now it doesn't happen as much as it used to. There are so many other kind of people and voices like in the world, and YouTube, and there's just so many different avenues now that people can put their work out. You can't just sit anymore and be like, oh yeah, it'll come to me, because it may if you're lucky, but it may not. I personally did a degree. I did a politics and history degree, and for me that was a really great, it wasn't a backup, because I mean, you can't, I'm obviously not, well, I could have been a politician, I guess, but it doesn't really lead like clearly into a job. But for me, it just gave me a much broader range of characters, I guess, or people to draw from when I was acting later in life, because I'd met so many people. I also just had a really good time. You learn how to write essays or like structure your arguments or research. I do a lot of research on my characters, so you learn how to research. So that's really good. So I would say maybe do a degree, but you know, obviously also do a drama degree. But obviously these days it's really expensive to do any of those. So if you can't afford to do those things, just start creating your own work. Go and work for free on productions. Like, go and be a runner. Go and dip your toe into every aspect of the industry that you can, because the more you know, the more you can utilize later in life. Just have fun. It's, you know, it's an amazing career if you have one. I wouldn't want to do anything else, but it is really hard. So just try not to take it too harshly if you're not getting where you want to be, and you know, just have a good time if you can. Go on, come on. Ask anything.
Eggs, how do you like them?
What?
Eggs.
Eggs.
How do you like them?
F- fertilized. No, I like them scrambled best. Oh, John.